Welcome back, sports fans. Today we are playing into BBPN. We're going to try this again, playing against Finhell here, running to Stardust Crusaders. So, as you can see, lots of players missing this game. Hadasaurus died, his big Saurus is out with an armor decrease, another one with block is missing. So he's got the Crocs, but you know, he's missing quite a bit. His skinks are in proper order. Has a movement up skink. Has a sprint sure feet skink, which is about the same. So, has a strength decrease skink that we can try to play. Lots of catch, so should be able to hand off the ball fairly readily. Gotta watch out for all of that. So, meanwhile, over here, you know, we've got guard on almost all the Tomb Guardians. Mighty Blow on almost all the Tomb Guardians. Jace doesn't need Mighty Blow. He's just that awesome. We do have an AG3 throw raw, which is going to be nice and, you know, doing his job. However, still makes him super vulnerable to getting hit. We had to get a new Gigamax here. So no tackle on the Blitzraw. That's going to be problematic. So, but we kind of need to win this game. If we win this game, we get ourselves out of Hooligan Division. And if we don't, then we don't. So, be interested to see what he takes. Takes Sleepy. Interesting pick. Especially since he paid out of pocket for some of that. That's a good chunk of change. It's almost half a Saurus. But he's going to try to make this a fight, I guess. Wizard could definitely fuck with Kenry, considering my lack of ball handling. Alrighty, so we are bending. I think we're going to play those. Normally, I would put my Tomb Guardians on the outside, but we really need to keep Jace as our only tackle piece. Pretty free if we can. Alrighty. So we did get the fame. That's going to be nice. So Sleevely's got block, grab, guard, stand firm. Stand firm shouldn't be a problem. Block's always nice. Guard's always nice. I never noticed that he's moving at 7. Sars is already so fucking fast. And without break tackle, that movement 7 really doesn't mean a ton. Yeah. There's a quite a bit riding on this though. So yeah, pretty much. If I can win this, it brings me up to like second or third for the division, something weird like that. It takes me out of Wooligan. That's all that really matters. High kick. High kick's not exactly what we want when he's got a bunch of catch skinks, but true enough. So, but you know, I would rather have 8 games where I can take maybe a loss or two than 8 games where I have to win every single match. Which is basically what Wooligan would be. So. So. But I'm a bit worried if he's grabbing me to here, that sounds like he might go for a foul. He does have loners. But that's fine. You can beat up Guinness. He steps forward. Interesting. Unlikely, but not impossible. No, you son of a bitch. There it goes, 1 by 2 throw-rolls, and it's the good one. Yeah. He's positioning for the foul. Well, now you got to. And you gotta break armor at this point. But 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's still a boss ball blitz from the blitz draw. Oh, it's a dodge, but just a stun. It is how real coaches coach cadet, you know, not playing fucking Chaos Dwarves. Let's take this 3 die. Skadoosh. Try to regroup a little bit. Got block. Nothing. Undead are. I've said many things about undead, all of which are true. Fuck 'em. Oh, we couldn't kill Osaurus, but he's not getting much in the way of hits this turn. So we got at least a removal, so hopefully limited fouling going on up now. Okay. Yep. Push. He's gonna have to tuck in like right here. Yep, there should work. Not sure. Well, see, Sleevely's got block stand for him, so. Boom. All right. Okay, so we need to get you moving, and we prefer you to probably be the Blitz. Let's go and make this the Blitz. Come on, Jace. You're not performing the way you should be. Let's go and get you over here. Get this block done. Of course, it's 1 and 9. The guard moving. We have no one to foul this turn. Of course, fucking gerbils every time. This should be a fairly straightforward turn for him. This block is kind, I would venture to say, might be one of the important ones because it determines if he can stall or not. With a push, I'm not sure that he really can. Grab means that that's all he needs to do. So, you can step up here, you can blitz out and score. Crox is a one die, that's a two die pill. You throw this block potentially, but no block there, so. Yep. All right. 6 turns to run it back. Should be plenty of time. We get our AG3 back. Yes, we do. All right. He got his KO back. All right. All right, I'll take a touchback. Right, first things first, throw that block. All right, was not expecting a stun. Quickly go ahead and throw that up. Triple stumbles. Triple stumbles. Look at this, we're just pushing skinks around. Really? Fucking, how many dice do I have to throw at two skinks to get any kind of result? It's not going bad, it's just annoying. Dodge is a good skill, you should take it. Block's a good skill, you should also take that. Unfortunately, I can't. I've gotten three doubles, two of them on the same fucking player. Of course he's going to dogpile my Tomb Guardian. For fuck's sake, really? How many triple fucking stumbles can you roll? Lizards are fast, but he's overcommitted, so we're gonna go for it. Try. Nope. I don't have a gap, but I have faith. Okay. Yes, to pal. Fucking. It's bad enough that I can't knock over his goddamn players, but the fact that he's breaking armor 10 regularly is not helping at all. He's using Sleebly very well, though. Start by getting you up and moving. Alright, let's throw this three die. Finally. Kill it. That's not killing it. That's KOing it, which, as we've shown, doesn't do enough. Throw this block. It's a push. Can we get you off? Yes, we can. Excellent. Saves me the trouble. This is why you get the big bucks. Step back here, lose a little ground, but that's fine because we've gotten removals this turn. It's not a huge loss. Because this is absolutely something that you can knock down with this guard piece. Just wasn't safe to stay over here. Saurus removal is huge when he's down Saurus is going in. So. Hey, Iceblade. Okay, he's crashing a cage. Okay, just a knockdown. We can work with that. We've got guard right here. Should be easy to get him off the ball. Okay, he does have block. Alright. Close to breaking armor, didn't quite pull it off there. Okay. That hurts. Because for some reason, skeletons got thick skull, but blitzers, not so much. If it weren't for the fact that block is such a goddamn good skill, probably wouldn't even take blitz draws. Stand you up. Yeah, I don't see you getting anything done this turn. Alright, let's throw this three die. Well, that means you can throw a two die. You got block. Stun. Okay. Make some magic happen. That's not making magic happen. That's just not fucking up. It's gonna be able to do stuff here. It is now one die. Cause we've got all other tackles covered. Should be horrible. We've got to make movement forward next turn now. Yeah, block over there. He doesn't. Okay, that keeps the Crocs busy for this turn. That's good. Let's see. He can blitz there for one die, but that's block on block. It would free up a skink, but to what avail? It is a one die block on no block. Yeah, that won't do anything for you. Of course he rolls the fucking both down. Of course he does. And it's an injury. Why not? It's Yark, after all. Yark regularly fucks us up. No matter what team it is. We're playing Underworld, we're playing Khemri. It's named after Yark. He fucking sucks. Okay, we have those. He got rerolls. There's the pal he wants. There's a bonehead. That's important? Might be. Get to moving. Think this is the blitz we want. Oh, that's a strength one, dude. All right. Of course, we fucking can't do that, right? Get it all up in there. These guys have guards, so that's not a problem. We've used a reroll for turn, so we're not going for it. Potato play, but you gotta do it. Yeah, I think he needs to make a dodge here to try to get this tackle piece down. That's twice. Definitely taking those boneheads. I don't think this one mattered a whole lot, but we take those where we can. Got block, he can push us. But that just leaves you a lone skink that can get to the ball. That probably should have been a blitz. Just so he can camp right here on top of the ball. Should I appeal? Pushes. It is diving tackle. Okay. How to best deal with the diving tackle bitch? Okay, we have one square of fucking around, but God, we cannot hit goddamn skinks. All right. If it is worth 3 die, I'd throw it. But we're trying to free him up because blitzing would have been the safest option. Son of a bitch. Oh, damn. I forget which of you bastards killed my tackle Blitzraw, but fuck you. It's been brutal not having that. Who did I play right before Cadet? Because I remember it was right before I played Cadet. Was it? No. I'll be honest, I don't even remember playing Scooter. Oh, good. He's still KO'd. Good job, Gigamax. And of course, we're out a Tomb Guardian, which fucking blows as well. All right. Blitz, of course. He's not going to scoop the ball on me, hopefully, but he can definitely apply pressure and he can definitely fuck up the front line. If it was Scooter, because Scooter's playing elves, isn't he? That would have been a disgrace. Yeah, some flavor of elf. Push, all right. It's not horrible.
So
His SARS is still out, so that helps. Stunty is a great skill if you can roll 3+. Is he gonna shoot all these down here? This one can just take the long way around. Start by putting you there. Of course, we can't knock over a skink with lock. Another 1 in 27, that's our third for the game. Push, stand firm. Bastard. There we go. Skeletons can apparently knock over skinks. Not anyone who is meant to. Go there. Go there. Skinks are strength 2. As long as we keep this guard bastard away, we're fine. Allows us to throw another 2 die. Alrighty.
Their advantage wanes. Prove your worth.
Oh, thanks for the follow, Ted. So. Just, this is a frustrating match. Wish my commentary was a little bit better. Just not a whole lot to add, and he's taking a fair bit of time to do his actions. Yep. Going for the $2 pill. Push. And fast bastards. Mighty blow, fucking worthless ass skill. Stun. That's huge. I can work with a stun there. This is the next safest block. Oh, that was you. I thought it was something smelly, but stay there. Lots of ones. I don't like the fact we're getting lots of ones. Make this the blitz. Fuck off. Oh. Well, KO is still good. push. Turn off my players. I'm not throwing this because if I don't knock him down, then he's just going to come and blitz the ball carrier. Even if I follow up, he can throw it, have these skinks block me off and free himself to come in here. And that's a problem. I need him to stay there. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. He can come in here, but he's going to have to dodge if he wants to hit me. That was a good turn. We stunned this bastard. We got a removal. And it was the diving tackle of all things. So. That helps. That's his fourth bonehead, I think, isn't it? It's third or fourth. Starting to feel better about this match right now, but shit can happen. Two diet pills can absolutely fuck me over. And he's already shown he's willing to do them, so. That's fine. Do it. You'll make all those dodges. I have no problem believing that that's gonna happen. Gonna move you down here. Guard and tackle are gonna be nice to have in the mix. This is gonna have to be the blitz. It's fine, gets you off of everything. Go and stand up. Excellent. We'll deal with you in a second. Throw this. Not what we wanted. He's not going to go anywhere because we had a Tomb Guardian. It's just this Crocs. I think I'd rather get you down here while things are a bit hairy. Stun's good enough. That was an important foul. You can throw that block. It's fine. Get you over there. Stay. I was like, I would have been fine even if he did get sent off. Getting this stun was important. But I'm happy that he didn't. It's a three die. It's a push. GFI, no problem. Okay. One die. Of course, one die pal. Why would it be anything else? Interesting. You want to dodge out? No? Alright. That is odd. Let's go and throw this three die block. God. Now I'm not even rolling stumbles. Now it's just pushes. Jump up is a good skill. So is block. Okay, he's stunned, so we can go ahead and move on over here. Let's throw this block. Excellent. Send him flying over there. Let him beat a skeleton's problem. That block. Okay, he's just gonna get up and move around. I have no good fouls to throw. We could foul this thing. Let's go and get it off the field. Do we just roll quad ones? I think we just rolled quad ones. Yeah. Good dice array. Solid. A plus. Right, boom. Can't hurt Creamfield. Me. I was finally getting knocked down. The stun fucking blows. This is a game where stuns actually matter, and it's annoying. It's an interesting move there. Should be able to plow you like your mother. All right, well, apparently we're gentle lovers. I think we have to go potato. I think we have to make sure that all the sources are tied up and. Hope for the best on that front. Barrel that block is our next safest. Okay, got that going for us. That was huge. Probably should have done this the other way around because we're then going to throw the throw raw right there. I wouldn't say huge, but successful turn. He can do a lot of moves to try to recover this. If Sleepley blitzes, he can get in front of the ball again. He's got open skinks to try to slow us down. Like, he's got things he can do. Surprised he took the book down instead of the free square movement. He parks on the blitz raw, which is again interesting. Dodging is not out of the question. Diving tackle's out, we have AG3. But if we're dodging, then we're leaving behind what protection we've got. And so far, he can't fail dodges. See, can't fail dodges. It's an important skill not failing dodges, especially when you're playing stunties. Not everyone has that skill. I just screwed myself on that positioning there. We have tackle, boys! We have tackle! It doesn't matter, because we can't hurt skinks. I need you to not fuck me here. You're fine there. All right, no rerolls. He can still very much pop this ball free, though. That is not a good turn. Has he used a reroll this entire game? I'm just curious. Obviously, he's not this half. I don't think he used any last half either. Which would be one thing if, like, all his buff guys had block and guard. But that's not even been the case. It's just, he doesn't fail blocks, he doesn't fail dodges. Fuck you, game, for proving me wrong. That's massive. I don't know why he was doing this dodge. He didn't need to do the dodge. This skink needed to run around here. This guy needed to stand up, and he had a one die block there. Unless he was just trying to blitz with Sleebly, but that seems unnecessary and silly. Yeah, let's do the safest thing possible. We need to get this ball moving. See, this is why we do the safe actions. Because the game likes to fuck with me. We're going to throw this block for reasons. Because now we can get you up all the way over here. Now we can throw this block. The game likes to fuck me. It likes to fuck with me, and it likes to just straight up fuck me. I think the only option he's got is a two-die pill. With a loner at that, so. Or you can go that way. The game likes to fuck me. Every single time. I told you this was going to come back and bite me in the ass. And it finally did. Okay, he's in scoring range. It's two GFIs with no fucking way that this is gonna be good. One die stumbles, of course. One die stumbles. He quit one die skull for once in his life. Of course. Of course. And we know how easily I can knock over skinks. It's the easiest thing in the world. I've done it every time. Regen's a myth. We don't have the skill. We never had the skill. We'll never have the skill. It doesn't matter what team we're playing. He has yet to roll a skull on any of his two die pills. The worst thing he has rolled is a both down push. I need a push here. You're getting rid of all my pals. So now we're not going to get it when we need it. Both down. Make sure he can't do some weird turn 16 bullshit. I stood up the wrong guy. Wonderful. Yep. Yeah. Yes. He's trying for bullshit. That's your best bet there. Casual sixes, why not? Do you got more in you? I think you do. Tackle, bitch! mean, we get a 2 on winnings, of course. And we lose Fan Factor. Wonderful. We had so much to lose. And the guy who didn't successfully foul a single thing this whole fucking game got MVP. Fifty-fifty pickups, failed all of our regens, got our one catch and our one dodge. Yep, that sounds about right. Oh, there's as many stumbles as pushes. More skulls than pals. Sounds about right. There's a lot. No. Birder or Jack Burton division is still lagging with like 3 pending matches. So. Oh, look at that. Did he get fucking the opposite dice array from us? Of course he did. Mere fucking image. Dodges were on point. So. GFIs. Tons of GFIs. None of those ones matter because they were all on sure feet. No, he had that one there on turn 16. I take that back. He had to reroll one of them. So. Also 100% pickup. Bonehead. Not horribly out of whack. Just. Night and day on block dice. So. Alright. So, for the division, let's see, there's a tiebreaker in there. I want to say Detox gets that because he should have the head-to-head. What is that? Jokers and Rata? Yeah. Detox beat T-squared, so he's going to get that tiebreaker. So, otherwise, fairly straightforward as a result. 4 fucking ties with Kemri. It's disgusting. Like, literally that win would have bumped us up to 4th. So scoot all these down. It would have been a massive win. So. But yeah, taking a look at